If you research any topic, do you stop after one knowledge source? That's how most AI will typically work today to generate responses. Instead, now with Foundry IQ and Microsoft Foundry, built-in AI-powered query decomposition and orchestration make it easy for your agents to find and retrieve the right information across multiple sources, autonomously iterating as much as required to generate smarter and more relevant responses than previously possible. And the good news is, as a developer, this all just works out of the box. And joining me to unpack everything and also show a few demonstrations of how it works is Pablo Castro, distinguished engineer and also CVP, is also the architect of Azure AI Search. So welcome back to the show.
It's great to be back.
And you've been at the forefront really for AI knowledge retrieval really since the beginning, where Azure AI Search is Microsoft's state-of-the-art search engine for vector and hybrid retrieval. And this is really key to building out things like reg-based agentic services and applications. So how have things evolved since then?
Things are changing really fast. Now, AI, and agents in particular, are expected to navigate the reality of enterprise information. They need to pull data across multiple sources and connect the dots as they automate tasks. This data is all over the place. Some in Azure stores, some in SharePoint, some is public data on the web, anywhere you can think of. Up until now, AI applications that needed to ground agents on external knowledge typically used a single index. If they needed to use multiple data sources, it was up to the developer to orchestrate them. With Foundry IQ and the underlying Azure AI Search retrieval stack, we tackled this whole problem. Let me show you. Here is a technician support agent that I built. It's pointed at a knowledge base with information from different sources that we pulled together in Foundry IQ. It provides our agent with everything it needs to know as it provides support to on-site technicians. Let's try it. I'll ask a really convoluted question, more of a stream of thought that someone might ask when working on a problem. I'll paste in equipment not working, CTL 11 light is red, maybe a power supply problem. Label on the equipment says P4324. The cord has another label, UL817. OK to replace the part. From here, the agent will give the question to the knowledge base, and the knowledge base will figure out which knowledge sources to consult before coming back with a comprehensive answer. So how did it answer this particular question? Well, we can see it went across three different data sources. The functionality of the CTL11 indicator is from the machine manuals. We receive them from different machine vendors, and we have them all stored in OneLake. Then, the company policy for repairs, which our company regularly edits, lives in SharePoint. And finally, the agent retrieved public information from the web to determine electrical standards.
And really, the secret sauce behind all of this is the knowledge base. So can you explain what that is and how that works?
So yeah, knowledge bases are first-class artifacts in Foundry IQ. Think of a knowledge base as the encapsulation of an information domain, such as technical support in our example. A knowledge base comprises one or more data sources that can live anywhere. And it has its own AI models for retrieval orchestration against those sources. When a query comes in, a planning step is run. Here, the query is deconstructed. The AI model refers to the source description or retrieval instructions provided, and it connects the different parts of the query to the appropriate knowledge source. It then runs the queries, and it looks at the results. A fast, fine-tuned SLM then assesses whether we have enough information to exit, or if we need more information and should iterate by running the planning step again. Once it has a high level of confidence in the response, it will return the results to the agent along with the source information for citations. Let's open the knowledge base for our technician support agent. And at the bottom, you can see our three different knowledge sources. Again, Machine Specs pulls markdown files from OneLake with all the equipment manuals. And notice the source description which Foundry IQ uses during query planning. Policies points at our SharePoint site with our company repair policies. And here's the web source for public information. And above, I've also provided retrieval instructions in natural language. Here, for example, I explicitly call out using web for electrical and industry standards.
And you're in Microsoft Foundry, but you also mentioned that Azure AI Search and the retrieval stack are really the underpinnings for Foundry IQ. So what if I already have some Azure AI Search running in my case?
Sure. Knowledge bases are actually AI search artifacts. You can still use standalone AI search and access these capabilities. Let me show you what it looks like in the Azure portal and in code. Here, I'm in my Azure AI Search service. We can see existing knowledge bases, and here's the knowledge base we were using in Foundry IQ. Flipping to VS Code, we have a new knowledge base retrieval client. And if you've used Azure AI Search before, this is similar to the existing search client, but focused on the agentic retrieval functionality. Let me run the retrieve step. The retrieve method takes a set of queries or a list of messages from a conversation and returns a response along with references. And here are the results in detail, this time purely using the Azure AI Search API. If you're already using Azure AI Search, you can create knowledge bases in your existing services and even reuse your existing indexes. Layering things this way lets us deliver the state-of-the-art retrieval quality that Azure AI Search is known for, combined with the power of knowledge bases and agentic retrieval.
Now that we understand some of the core concepts behind knowledge bases, how does it actually work then under the covers?
Well, unlike the classic RAG technique that would typically use one source with one index, we can use one or more indexes as well as remote sources. When you construct a knowledge base, passive data sources such as files in OneLake or Azure Blob Storage are indexed, meaning that Azure Search creates vector and keyword indexes by ingesting and processing the data from the source. We also give you the option to create indexes for specific SharePoint sites that you define while propagating permissions and labels. On the other hand, data sources like the web or MCP servers are accessed remotely, and we support remote access mode for SharePoint too. In these cases, we'll effectively use the index for the connected source for data for retrieval. Surrounding those knowledge sources, we have an agentic retrieval engine powered by an ensemble of models to run the end-to-end query process that is used to find information. I wrote a small visualization tool to show you what's going on during the retrieval process. Let me show you. I'll paste the same query we used before and just hit run. This uses the Azure AI Search knowledge base API directly to run retrieval and return both the results and details of each step. Now, in the returned result, we can see it did two iterations and issued 15 queries total across three knowledge sources. This is work a person would have had to do manually while researching. In this first iteration, we can see it broke the question apart into three aspects: equipment details, the meaning of the label, and the associated policy. And it ran those three as queries against the selected set of knowledge sources. Then the retrieval engine assessed that some information was missing, so it iterated and issued a second round of searches to complete the picture. Finally, we can see a summary of how much effort we'd put in tokens, along with an answer synthesis step, where it provided a complete answer along with references. And at the bottom, we can see all the reference data used to produce the answer was also returned. This is all very powerful because as a developer, you just need to create a knowledge base with the data sources you need, connect your agent to it, and Foundry IQ takes care of the rest.
So how easy is it then to build a knowledge base out like this?
This is something we've worked really hard on to reduce the complexity. We've built a powerful and simplified experience in Foundry. Starting in the Foundry portal, I'll go to build, then to knowledge in the left nav and see all the knowledge bases I already created. Just to show you the options, I'll create a new one. Here, you can choose from different knowledge sources. In this case, I'll cancel out of this and create a new one from scratch. We'll give it a name, say repairs, and choose a model that's used for planning and synthesis, and define the retrieval reasoning effort. This allows you to control the time and effort the system will put into information retrieval, from minimum, where we just retrieve from all the sources without planning, to higher levels of effort, where we'll do multiple iterations assessing whether we got the right results. Next, I'll set the output mode to answer synthesis, which tells the knowledge base to take the grounding information it's collected and compose a consolidated answer. Then I can add the knowledge sources we created earlier. And for example, I'll reduce the machine specs that contains the manuals that are in OneLake and our policies from SharePoint. If I want to create a new knowledge source, I can choose supported stores in this list. For example, if I choose Blob Storage, I just need to point at the storage account and container, and Foundry IQ will pull all the documents, do chunking, vectorization, and everything needed to make it ready to use. We'll leave things as is for now. Instead, something really cool is how we also support MCP servers as knowledge sources. Let's create a quick one. Let's say we want to pull software issues from GitHub. All I need to do is point it to the GitHub MCP server address and set search issues as the tool name. At this point, I'm all set, and I just need to save my changes. if data needs to be indexed for some of my knowledge sources, that will happen in the background, and indexes are continually updated with fresh information.
And to be clear, this is hiding a ton of complexity, but how do we know it's actually working better than previous ways for retrieval?
Well, as usual, we've done a ton of work on evaluations. First, we measured whether the agentic approach is better than just searching for all the sources and combining the results. In this study, the gray lines represent the various data sets we used in this evaluation. And when using query planning and iterative search, we saw an average 36% gain in answer score, as represented by this green line. We also tested how effective it is to combine multiple private knowledge sources and also a mix of private sources with web search, where public data can fill in the gaps when internal information falls short. We first spread information across 9 knowledge sources and measured the answer score, which landed at 90%, showing just how effective multi-source retrieval is. We then removed 3 of the 9 sources, and as expected, the answer score dropped to about 50%. Then we added a web knowledge source to compensate for where our 6 internal sources were lacking, which in this case was publicly available information. And that boosted results significantly. We achieved a 24-point increase for low retrieval reasoning effort and 34 points for medium effort. Finally, we wanted to make sure we only iterate if it'll make things better. Otherwise, we want to exit the agentic retrieval loop. Again, under the covers, Foundry IQ uses 2 models to check whether we should exit: a fine-tuned SLM to do a fast check with a high bar, and if there is doubt, then we'll use a full LLM to reassess the situation. In this table, on the left, we can see the various data sets used in our evaluation, along with the type of knowledge source we used. The fast check and the full check columns indicate the number of times as a percentage that each of the models decided that we should exit the agentic retrieval loop. We need to know if it was a good idea to actually exit. So the last column has the answer score you would get if you use the minimal retrieval effort setting, where there is no iteration or query planning. If this score is high, iteration isn't needed. And if it's low, iteration could have improved the answer score. You can see, for example, in the first row, the answer score is great without iteration. Both fast and full checks show a high percentage of exits. In each of these, we saved time and tokens. The middle 3 rows are cases where the fast check defers to the full check, and the full check predicts that we should exit at reasonable high percentages, which is consistent with the relatively high answer scores for minimal effort. Finally, the last 2 rows show both models wanting to iterate again most of the time, consistent with the low answer score you would have seen without iteration. So as you saw, the exit assessment approach in Foundry IQ orchestration is effective, saving time and tokens while ensuring high quality results.
Foundry IQ then is great for connecting the dots then across scattered information while keeping your agents simple to build. And there's no orchestration required. It's all done for you. So how can people try Foundry IQ for themselves right now?
It's available now in public preview. You can check it out at aka.ms/FoundryIQ.
Thanks so much again for joining us today, Pablo, and thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe to Microsoft Mechanics for more updates, and we'll see you again soon.